Hello, this is Kavya from Edureka, here to explain how to choose the right career. At first, we'll look at an introduction to understand why choosing the right career is important. Then we'll see what is self-evaluation. We'll have a brief on job market research. Based on the jobs we've looked at, we'll talk to industry professionals. And then, to pick a career, we need to identify skills gap and upskill accordingly. With this, shortlist a set of ideal career possibilities out of the protective options. Short-term hands-on experience on these careers will help us be surer of our decision. Once you are all set, ace the interview. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to Edureka YouTube channel and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Also, if you are interested in online training certification, do check out the link given in the description. Before wondering how to choose the right career, we need to understand its importance. Choosing a career is one of the most important decisions you will make in life. It's about so much more than deciding what you will do to make a living. To start with, think about the amount of time we spend at work. According to Gettysburg, an average person spends 90,000 hours of their entire lifetime at work. This is equivalent to almost one-third of the active years of lifetime. Choosing the right career is a big challenge that everyone goes through. Make sure not to just have a career for the sake of it, but to have the right career. According to the Economic Times, only 2 out of 10 people are actually satisfied with their jobs. But why is that so? Is the wrong choice of career causing it? The lack of clarity about a field and making choices based on family or peer pressure can lead to very wrong career decisions. When a child is asked, "What do you want to become in future?" they have marvelous answers, such as doctors, astronauts, AIS officers, chefs, and whatnot. These are mostly impacted by parents or other successful people in the family. This is the conditioning of mind where the person answers without thinking, but as an adult, it should not be so. Over time, we need to analyze thoroughly to end up in the right career. Choosing the right career can guarantee happiness. When we do what we like, we do it well. This in turn can help us grow and achieve success. And success in turn makes us happier. The first step to choosing the right career is to have a self-evaluation. To start with evaluating oneself, a SWOT analysis can be performed. A SWOT analysis is a strategic planning technique used to help a person or organization identify strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats related to any planning. Make a chart to understand what's helpful and harmful for you internally as well as externally. From internal origin, what's helpful for you are your strengths. To identify these, ask yourself questions like, what do you do well? What unique resources can you draw on? What do others compliment about you? Along with strengths, you need to identify your weaknesses too. These are your internal negatives, which you need to work on. To figure it out, ask questions such as, what could you improve? Where do you have fewer resources than others? What others don't like about you? So once you have identified your internal factors, move on to the external origins. Identify the opportunities. Find out what opportunities are open to you. What trends can you take advantage of? How can you turn your strengths into opportunities? That's the way your strengths can be made use of. To avoid getting into trouble later, identify the threats before getting started in a career. Figure out what threats can harm you. What is your competitor doing? What threats do your weaknesses require aspect to pay? Take time in making this chart. However, SWOT analysis in itself may not be enough to know oneself. We need to evaluate ourselves better. For this, we need to set priorities and at the same time balance expectations. It might not be practical to have a bachelor's degree with no experience and expect a very senior position in the company. Another way to measure ourselves is to take up self-assessment tests. It helps us identify our personality traits. Would we be a good fit for creative jobs, managerial positions, and so on? Figure out your expectations out of a job. Do you want to go for a long-term career, or do you have monetary emergencies? This helps us not wander around jobs which don't match the role expectation we had in mind. Find where your core interest lies. What your hobbies are can speak a lot about you. Let's say a person into fashion or makeup may not identify their exact job fit, but they know what industry to follow through. And of course, your skill set. From soft skills to technical skills, this is what is going to get you hired. Once you have evaluated yourself, it's now time to evaluate the trends around you. So step two of how to choose the right career is to research the job market. After identifying our core skills and interests, we need to know what's going on in the world. According to a report by NASSCOM, out of the 5 to 5.5 million graduates that pass out every year, only about 14% are considered employable in the Tier 1 and Tier 2 companies. It was noticed that in the non-BPM space, IT services, engineering, and R&D software products, around 24 to 26% of the candidates are employable in the Tier 1 and Tier 2 organizations. This insight is based on a research conducted with participation from employers like Infosys, TCS, HCL, Genpact, etc., which identified the factors used to filter out candidates in the recruitment process. The three factors used for this filtering were academic performance, technical aptitude and soft skills, and how well-versed or certified a candidate is. So in order to research the job market, we need to make sure we are eligible in these factors. Today, the job market is wide, from different industries to different roles. Hence, you need to dig deep in your research. Consider not just salary, but also the growth prospect, scope in future, and vacancies in each of the jobs. Once you have done your research well, you should be inclined to a few options. The next step is to learn about those industries by talking to industry experts. Having one-to-one conversation with someone working on your dream field can give you a lot of insight. Talk to someone you know from your family pursuing a career or someone in your contact. Check out websites like LinkedIn or any job portal where people work in your preferred industry. Take proper details from them in your conversation. List out your key findings about that particular job, about the skills and industry in general. The next step is to identify the skill gap and upskill. Now you know about your own skills from self-evaluation as well as the skills required in the jobs according to your research. There's out to be a gap between these, but not to worry. EduReka has numerous courses that will help you upskill and bridge this gap in majority of the cases. With this, the next step is to shortlist the ideal career possibilities among the wide sea of options. The first step to shortlist is to eliminate each of the career paths that does not interest you or has weak job load. If following a long-term path with determination does not nearly guarantee a fruit, it's not advisable to follow such a path at all. Next, analyze the growth opportunity and salary. If a career path seems to remain stagnant with too much growth, it should be out of your list. Terminate the options that don't match your expectations. We all have some minimal expectations that we wouldn't want to negotiate on, so stick to it. In the end, pick not more than 3 to 4 jobs shortlisted from the options. With this, you are ready to skyrocket up. For the shortlisted options, try getting some short-term hands-on experience. Some first-hand experience in what you would do in the coming years helps you make sure that you are not making a wrong decision. This short-term experience can be some project, internship, or even fellowship, depending on your field. Do something yourself to get a taste of what the rest of your career might look like. With this, you are all set to ace the interview. Take no chances in your right career. Make sure you outperform others as well as yourself in the past in the interview. Strengthen your resume. Make sure it's relevant to the job role. Add certifications you have earned that emphasize your skill set. Add the top projects you have completed or past experience, if any. Be confident throughout your interview. When you are well-versed in the requirements, you can definitely get the job. Hopefully, this will guide you through how to choose the right career. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any doubts, please leave a message in the comment section. Happy learning.
I hope you have enjoyed listening to this video. Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries, and we will reply them at the earliest. Do look out for more videos in our playlist and subscribe to EduReka channel to learn more. Happy learning!